Hello, and welcome to Season 2 of A Physician's Lens, a series of recurring conversations with members of HCA Healthcare's physician and clinician community on topics of shared interest. Today, I think we have a really interesting topic. It's about care transformation and innovation. And our guest today is Dr. Michael Schlosser. Dr. Schlosser is a neurosurgeon. His pedigree is really quite remarkable. He was an MIT undergraduate, did medical school at Yale, completed his neurosurgery residency at Johns Hopkins, and actually has had an illustrious career going after his academic training to the FDA, where he helped in the device department, and then came to HCA Healthcare through clinical practice at Centennial Hospital and a number of physician leadership roles, but was the inaugural chief medical officer of HCA's Health Trust Purchasing Group. For the last few years, he has been the chief medical officer of our national group, and in that role has had tremendous responsibility for lots of innovative activity. But today, we're going to hear about a new organization in HCA Healthcare called the Care Transformation and Innovation Program. So Mike, welcome, and tell us a little bit about CTNI. HCA does a lot of innovative things, but this is really specifically focused.
Yes, thanks, and thanks for having me here, John. And you're spot on. HCA has a long history of innovation, and our operators and clinicians solve problems through innovative methods all the time. So what's different about care transformation and innovation, or CTNI as we like to call it, is really two main things. The first is what we call purpose-driven innovation. So we've really set out a goal over the next 5 years to really transform the way healthcare is delivered in our hospitals, to transform the model of care into one that is highly effective, highly efficient, and takes advantage of all the advanced technology that we have access to. And so staying focused on that goal and making steady progress over the next 5 years and not getting caught up in the day-to-day pressures of operations will give us some freedom, we hope, to really be transformative. The other thing that's different is the space that we've been granted by the organization. So HCA is a tremendous operating company, but we also are constantly busy and constantly taking care of patients and growing and expanding. And so we at CTNI will have some space, both in an innovation hub hospital, as well as a dedicated team that really can spend our time focused on executing on the care transformation agenda.
Was there something that precipitated the decision as to why now?
Clearly, the pandemic was one of the catalysts for this. So coming out of the pandemic, we had a lot of lessons learned. Some, I would say, are positive lessons and some maybe not so positive. On the positive side, we saw HCA's ability to really innovate and transform and quickly when we needed to. When the pressures of the pandemic posed themselves, we deployed new models of care and new technologies, sometimes in a matter of days, because the pressure required us to. And so we saw that we had that capacity and capability to innovate and transform in that way. We also unfortunately saw some of the weaknesses of the care model that we currently use. When pressures like a new disease that we didn't understand or the staffing pressure that came with the pandemic posed itself, we didn't maybe have the flexibility and capability to adapt as quickly as we really wanted to. And so, again, we saw an opportunity, really, to put those things together and figure out how can we use the scale and the resources of HCA really to drive change. The third thing I would point out would be the digital capabilities. So there's been tremendous advancements in machine learning, artificial intelligence, cloud computing, which can handle trillions of lines of data and do so nimbly. And so all of that capability is at our fingertips, but we really need a dedicated effort to figure out how do we unlock the capability there and the magic that can bring. And so with partnership with Google and some of our other key vendors, we really feel like we can put some focus around unlocking the power of that real-time data and that digital transformation work.
So we're surrounded by information, and we have so many sensor systems or potential sensor systems ranging from IVs to all the monitors, et cetera. So you're really thinking about an architecture in which the data come to a capacity to really analyze that data, provide real-time decision support, automate where possible, and through that process achieve digitally enabled and better clinical outcomes.
Yeah, that's spot on. We really do want to get to that real-time, in-the-moment decision-making. We've done tremendous work with the data warehouse that we currently have, a lot of times looking mostly at retrospective data, but we really want to flip that switch and have operators and clinicians have insights in the moment about how they can best care for patients.
Okay, well, let's make it real. Give me an example of some of the initial use cases and what this will look like.
Sure, and so we've created a little bit of a lexicon of how we talk about our work. So we're developing care transformation products, and then those individual products will have features inside of them, which are kind of the building blocks to get to the larger goal. So the first care transformation product we're focused on is in the labor and delivery space. So we see tremendous opportunity there to eliminate some of the errors that can sometimes occur. As you know, despite the fact that HCA does relatively well with labor and delivery, the United States as a whole doesn't do as well as some other developed countries. And so we see an opportunity, not just within HCA, but outside, to have a tremendous impact on laboring moms. So a digital approach to labor and delivery with a safety net that provides both organization and efficiency and safety of care is the big goal, the long-term goal. And then a couple of the initial features we'll work on are, first, a digital approach to staffing, scheduling, and care team assignment. We've got to have the right people on the field taking care of the right patients if we're going to be successful in the long term. And so a real digitized approach to that also creates a foundational data asset for us to understand our care teams going forward. And then the second piece is around a proactive response to fetal distress. So monitoring moms and their babies for signs of distress is kind of the foundational activity of an L&D unit. And so bringing an intelligent approach to that, where the computer system can help the caregivers understand in context of the mom and the unit and everything else going on, what the various systems like the fetal heart monitor are telling them, and react in a proactive way so we prevent bad outcomes rather than being reactive, is another foundational digital technology we want to bring forward. So those are some of the first things we'll be working on.
Yeah, I know our terrific Chief Information Officer, Marty Pasolik, likes to say he wants to get to the post-dashboard world, and this really sounds like that. So we're not looking at data in the last quarter, but really trying to plan and execute the plays for the next quarter.
That's absolutely right. And we see the work we're currently doing in L&D as absolutely having application across the entire hospital. So these are some first steps we're going to take, and then hopefully we'll accelerate and we'll have 6 or 8 of these types of projects going on at any time.
So I'm sure many in our obstetrical community would like to be involved in this, and I'm sure many across our physician and clinician community would like to get involved. How can members of our HCA Healthcare clinical community get involved in this exciting work?
And their involvement actually is critical to success. So we don't in any way think we have all the answers within our small CTNI team. And so we have a number of ways that we want to engage with our key leaders and stakeholders across the organization. One is through what we're calling our surfacing and sensing program, which is where we'll do kind of a proactive ask. We'll go out and let the community know we're working in this space in L&D, and here's the kinds of ideas we're looking for, and extract some of those best ideas. Maybe we have some pilots out there going on that we didn't even know about. The second is through an advisory board structure we look to stand up, and this will be multidisciplinary. We really are focused on care teams working together as teams, so we need everyone who is involved in that care team to be part of our advisory board structure so they can help us think about these problems and their solutions. And then lastly, we're looking to develop a broad ecosystem, really reach out side of HCA, connect with other key thought leaders, other organizations, payers, technology vendors, anyone that can bring forward kind of the best of what's out there in healthcare today to help us solve for some of these big problems.
Well, Mike, that sounds incredibly exciting. And if you want to get involved, you heard the offer here, Dr. Michael Schlosser. He's on Outlook. A little danger in that, but I know you and your team welcome the inputs. Thanks for leading this. We're going to continue to innovate in the day-to-day activities, but this is really an edge approach to really using the best of digital technology and automation and new models of care to make quantum leaps in the way that we provide care and achieve better outcomes. I know that Mike and I also want to take a moment just to say thank you for all that you do. We know that the last year and a half with COVID has been exceptionally difficult, and we want to just appreciate that you have been here despite personal and professional challenges. So thanks for all you do for HCA Healthcare, for the patients and the communities we're privileged to serve, and we look forward to seeing you next time.